And that is our big story tonight, violating a veteran.
A Vietnam War veteran targeted by three men outside his Milwaukee home. Suzanne Spencer is live at Milwaukee Police District 4 with how he got away. Suzanne?
Mary and Ted, this 66-year-old man was headed to his garden this morning and saw three men approach him. What happened next, though, got Milwaukee Police District 4 detectives involved in trying to figure out who these men are. On a day honoring the sacrifice of veterans, this Vietnam War veteran found himself using his instinct from his days at war at his Milwaukee home.
He was getting ready to go to the garden this morning, and I guess three young guys came and tried to rob him with the gunpoint.
On the right, as Saley Vang sits in his car, three men approach from down the alley. They close in on the car, one with a gun visible, before demanding Vang's keys. As he gets out, he doesn't give them the keys, but walks away before the suspects take off. His son standing alongside him in the hours after.
Scariest thing would be losing my dad right there, because I saw the video. They actually have the gun pointed at him.
As the suspects ran, the video shows Vang run after them. What it doesn't show, though, is him getting back in his car, taking off after them before his car was struck with four bullets.
There's one there and one by the gas tank right here.
A neighbor's car was also struck, but the 66-year-old vet would be okay.
Very startled, but he said, you know, like, he was in the war, in the Vietnam War too, so it doesn't really faze him.
Not fazed in the face of evil and a bullet still wedged inside of his car.
He looked at them, he said, today's not my day to go.
And he showed very fearlessly today was not his day to go. He gave police his surveillance, told them his story. He guesses that two of those men involved were carrying guns, and he also suspects they were in their teens. Anyone with information about this should give Milwaukee police a call. Reporting outside Milwaukee Police District 4, Suzanne Spencer, Fox 6 News.
Suzanne, thank you.